welcome to Markham, Canada for the 2018 BWF World Junior Champion Team Event. We are here in Markham Pan Am Center, home to the 2015 Pan Am Games Badminton event, located just outside Toronto, Ontario, and an hour and a half drive from the spectacular Niagara Falls, Canada. And that's what they're playing for, that prestigious cup. It's the 16th edition to the World Junior Team Championships, 41 countries, 449 athletes from all five BWF Continental Federations are gathered here to battle it out to be the next Junior World Champion. Well, this is a quarterfinals draw. China had a little bit of a tough time up against Malaysia. They lost the mixed doubles going into that. And then the men's singles and men's doubles were just 2 points short. Takes at 3-1. Japan had an easy time, 3-0, and that's what we're looking at. It's China versus Japan. Starting off with the mixed doubles. Gao and Li have the advantage. They're ranked number one in the world. And this is what's gonna make the big difference, getting that first point right off the bat. Then it's the men's singles. He's number three in the world, Li Shifeng. He won the Youth Olympic Games not too long ago, but he has his battle against the Japanese, Kohei Nakahara. Coming onto the court, it's the mixed doubles. Japan to lead the way. Well, there you have China Gao and Liu. Liu's number one in the women's doubles and the mixed doubles in the world currently. And head-to-head, it's 1-1. The last meeting, not too long ago, and the second game was close. First game, 21-12, and then 21-19. Coin toss, we can decide who serves first, or what side. There's a little bit of a drift in this venue. So we decide to take the side first. There's Yao Shenhua, 18 years of age, 176 centimeters tall. Highest world ranking is number two, and that's where he currently sits right now. Very strong doubles player as well, and there's her partner, Liu Shuanshuan. Another 18-year-old talent, 170 centimeters tall. She's ranked number one, both in the mixed doubles and the women's doubles. And this is the way they got into the semifinals. Germany, two straight games, and Hong Kong, and then that's where they faltered in the Malaysian. They lost to the Malaysians in two straight games in the quarterfinals. Hiroki Hirokawa, 18 years old, 161 centimeters. Currently ranked 23 in the world. And his partner, Natsu Saito, 18 as well, 168 centimeters tall. And she's currently ranked 23, and her highest ranking was 6 in the world. The reason for this Japanese team, on paper, their ranking is lower. You take your best 7 results, and they only have 5 tournaments. And here's the way they got here. They were pushed against Thailand, 44 minutes. They lost that one. And against Chinese Taipei, two straight get sets, 21-18, 21-13. So pushed a little bit, lost one against Thailand.
Ready to play.
There's our umpire for today, Lila. From Indonesia. Our service stretch. John Jojen. One by night. Bahrain. Final preparations. Two serves. Japan up in blue on the near side.
Running.
This team competition, it starts off with the mixed doubles.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and singles.
On my right, Japan, represented by Midori Kawahiroki and Saito Matsu. And on the left, China, represented by Guo Xinguo and Liu Shunfeng. Japan deserves.
Japan starts it off with the serve, with the team on the near court in blue, very quick. You watch Hiroki, he's so quick on his feet, and that's his key. Very solid defense, but it's the speed that he has that makes a difference. Well, China does have an advantage going into this. They're number one seeds on the far side.
It's
Liu on the far side. She is very strong, cutting off, moving around the court so well. So they have an edge going into this match. And that just goes long out the back.
Three left.
Teammates like this, a nice fist pump. And that goes wide. Well, the Japan on a 5-point lead to start it off. Again, really taking control of the first game. Now China, first point to get on the board.
Service over, 1-5.
And another easy mistake, puts it into the net. The racket was
service
there.
Service over,
just snapped
six,
at it,
one.
Too much.
Service over, 2-6.
Right off the serve. The serve was a little bit weak. Ideally, you just want it just to almost scrape the tape 5 feet in the middle. And great attack from Japan. Gets another point.
Service over, 3-7.
18 years of age. All the players, you have to be under 19 as of January 1st. The team event is a mixed doubles, men's singles, men's doubles, and a women's doubles. In the round robin, you played all of them, but now we're down to the semifinals. So whoever gets the first 3 points wins the tie. It's an easy point out the back. China's closing the gap now by two. Mixing up the angles of the attack, very smart. It's not always hard and steep. Came up on her body on that one. Oh, beautiful spot. There it goes. Down to the ground, he has it. Comes in so quick, he gets his racket on it. Goes cross court, watch this, how quick it is. Finds a hole. Beautiful position. And that time, smashes high. Saito couldn't return it. And another unforced error by Saito, kind of got caught into her body moving in on that one. China now down by two. And that's a righty-lefty combo. If you watch them on the far side, the Chinese duo, the way she cuts off the shots, she's trying to set up her partner as well. And that just sails out the side. Another mistake into the net. China evens it off at 10 apiece.
10-0.
Well, down 5-0 to start it off. Japan came out quick. And there you have it, into the break. China now leading the first time in this match. 11-10 in 7 minutes of play. Again, getting on the attack, that's what made the difference for China in the second half of that beginning. Cut down on the unforced errors and definitely trying to use their power.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Well, Saito. A few mistakes, but they were actually just putting the pressure on her at the end, trying to force her to make the mistakes.
11-10.
Also a very good women's doubles player. We might see her at the last match of the day. She'll be back on court in the women's doubles. Again, now mentally trying to force the shot. He was there on that one, an easy one and into the net. Just watch. Good defense from China. And another mistake. Well, China's on a roll now, 13-10. Oh, definitely Japan was strong coming out, but now mentally, you just see a little deflation in them.
Service over. 11-13.
Finally, Japan able to get that point, what they needed. Right thought.
Service over.
Mitarikawa knew what to do there. There was an opening, but just into the net, too tight. Now China up by 3. That's better. Nice drop to set that one up. Mix it up. That's what you always have to do. It's not all about the power of the game. It's also trying to find those spots, and that's what he did with that drop shot and then puts a hammer to it. Easy cut off that time by Gao. Again. He's there, he's very clever. If you watch, Mitaroki on the court, he's very fast, knows what to do, but that's just trying to force it a little too much. There is a lot of pressure on this. Japan has never won the World Junior Championships in the team event. China basically owns that title here. This team event has been played since 2000. China has won 12 times. They missed it 3 times. They won a silver and a bronze, and they missed competing one of the times. So 12 out of 15, that's a pretty good stat. So they won it again. Again, the pressure too much. Liu gets her racket up there, keeps the pressure on. Watch this, how quick she is. Comes in, puts it away. You're able to watch how Liu comes off the net, comes back and forth just a little bit. She's in the right spot most of the time. Her partner tries to set her up at the net and able to put it away.
Service over, 14-18.
Okay, Another miss hit into the net. On the first one, but too much and puts it into the net. And if you watch Midorikawa, he's very quick. He gets a height on his smashes. Saito in the right spot. And there we have first game point. It's 2014. China on the far side. There we go. That one, Saito is all over that one. Again, it was a set up from the drop. That's what I would like to see more of. Hiroki has a lot of power and steep smashes, but it's when he sets it up with that drop shot, they seem to win the points. Straight smash, great angle on that one. Saves another game point.
16-20.
Change the shuttles, but they say no, let's keep playing, we're on a run, they don't want to change the shuttle now. They did him. Now with a big, powerful smash
first
at the back.
One by
on the last
China,
point.
21-17.
Saito, a little bit too much out the side, but it's a power from China. They take the first game, 21-17, 2 minutes of play. China on the near court in red. Liu Shuanshuan to serve. With a power attack. That's what they did in the first game. China really got on attack. At the beginning of the game, they were making the mistakes. Then Gao really used his powerful smash. That lefty goes down the middle. Sets up his partner. And that's what made the difference in the first game. And the far side is Japan in blue. Roki return the serve. Yorikawa. Natsu Saito. That's a tough one. There's a lot of pressure here. All of them are just 18 years of age. It's the semifinals of the World Team Championships. Perfect spot, right in the box. And that's a lefty. You get away with that once in a while on the game. Powerful left-handed shot. You do play more righties, so you try to find those holes, but that time it was right into his forehand. Excellent execution. Saito just looks a little bit uneasy on the far side. Made a few unforced errors, and that's what Japan does so well. They're so steady on court. And it's very frustrating when they make these mistakes because usually that's not what they do on court. So you just see her shaking her head once in a while. Also a big mental game. Almost. Saito just looking for his partner. There she is. Just hits the tape. Beautiful return. Gets it back and puts it to the ground. Take that. That's the speed. That's what I was talking about. That's how he started the first game. Looking for those holes, especially in mixed doubles, you want to play the mid-court shots. You're looking in between the players on the far side. Oh, great rally. That time came across his body. The angles are hard. That's the most important thing in badminton, always changing the angles, whether it's deep, high, or coming across the bodies. Very smart placement on that shot. There's speed again. Yorikawa comes in nice and quick. So fast on his, places it beautifully. Watch this. Nobody home. Well done. Oh, what a rally. Just off the tape. No chance on that one. Puts it to the ground. Excellent played rally by all four players out there on court. The net in the favor of Japan on that one. Able just to hit the tape.
Quick telling.
Yeah, hard one to get back. Just barely gets it back.
Okay. On court, please. Seven, five.
Watch out. Surprise on that call from Japan.
Eight.
Just sailed out the back. China down by two. Oh, too bad on that one. Very good. Guys, we knew what to do. We tried the deception. That time, Saito, nice and steady throughout the whole rally. Very smart playing on her part. A little too much and into the net.
Play.
For a towel down and wiping up the court.
Okay, thank you. On court. Put the towel inside.
Well, there we have the Chinese squad. 20 players they brought. 10 girls, 10 guys to Markham, Ontario. Training in the first 5 days, we've had 8 courts going all at once. There's a beautiful facility. All the 2015 Pan American Games here. Badminton, table tennis, and water polo is held here in this venue. This time Japan's into the break at 11-7. Taking control in the second game. And we'll get confirmation, 11-7 in 11 minutes of play. Japan's in the lead in the second game, 11-7. On the far side in blue, China takes the first game, 21-17. A little bit too much. The righty lefty combo, she knows was probably easier for her to reach on that one. Service fault called, too high. Saito puts that one to the ground. Time into the net. You felt the pressure on the other side. Even if you're not going to hit it, you have that pressure on there. It's a hard one to return. Watch this. He sees him. Beautiful shot from Gao. Again, a lot of power. Gets behind that smash. It's a very hard smash. Comes straight down to the ground. Gao working hard out on there. You can see how much he's breathing. A strong guy, lots of power, working so hard. Now China ties it up, 13 all. Caught that shuttle really low. Let it drop down and into the net. Well, took four tries, but put it to the ground. Again, little Reed Kawa snaps it down the first one, not enough, puts it away. Now in the lead again. Defense from Japan. Nice and solid. Gets it to the back of the court. Excellent mix up. Good get again from Liu. Oh, what a rally that time into the net. Could just see his elbow dropping on that one. Forced it too much. And ties it up at 14 apiece. Watch this. Excellent smash. See how low he hit that? The angles. That's what you have to think about. The angles in badminton. Where your elbow is and if you can hit those shots. If not, you have to take the pace off or change the angles.
Set is over. 14 all. Thank you.
powerful smash down the line, takes the point. Japan takes the lead again, 15-14. Watch the angle on this one. Nice height. Nails the line. Yeah, I wasn't sure if to leave it or not, but with that fist pump, he knows it was out. Leaving it off again. Stake, unforced error, too much pressure.
How important this first tie. This mixed doubles really means a lot to the rest of the team. If we can get this win.
Defense too much and out the side. That's who Saito had the pressure on her though. Got some fantastic defense on there. A short lift, and that's when it's punished. If they can find that back line, it's not a problem, but if they're short, Gao just hits so hard at the back. So quick coming into the net. Well, it's a battle on court. And Japan likes what they see right now. Just down by 1 point in the second game. 35 minutes of play. Great defense now from Gao, really moving him, not just from one spot, side to side, really keeping that pressure on. Oh, what defense, crouch position. Well done, Saito that time. Really fighting for it. Gao with the big hammers, really comes hard. Watch that, just able to get that one back. Incredible get. The serve, and there's the Chinese team. That time into the net.
Set is over, 18-19.
Pressure that time out the side. China with match point.
That is over, 20, match point, 18.
Not yet. We saved another match point. Rikawa, court put away on that one. 19-20. It's
to flick. Oh, a quick flick to the back. 20 apiece. Japan likes it. You have to win by two. The game goes to 21 points, but you have to win by 2 points. Side toe, steady on her defense on that one. Oh, Shinhwa, big, powerful, trying to go cross court. Now, Japan, the first game point. Saved it.
Service over, 21.
Shinhwa with a great push. Evened it off at 21 again. Little luck from the tape. Roki will take it. A little fist pump on that one. Waited to the end. Another game point for Japan, 22-21. They get it. Second time asking, 22.
Second game,
Japan
won by
takes the second
Japan.
Game, 23-21.
One game point.
There's confirmation of the score in the second game. Took a little extra, 23-21.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
Well, it's game three of the mixed doubles. China on the far side in red. Take the first game, 21-17. And a hard-fought battle for Japan, 23-21 in the second game. And now we're in the decider.
That is over, one left.
There's been a lot of ups and downs in this match, and all four of them are working super hard on court. They cut down on a few of the unforced errors, settled in. The rallies have been fantastic.
not to go around, yeah? This is the one. That is over 2-1.
Again at two apiece, all four players 18 years of age. Saito, the one that's serving, we'll see her at the last game. In fact, three of these four players will be playing again in the doubles. Gao is only playing the mixed doubles, but all the other three will be playing women's doubles at the very end and the men's doubles. Rikawa is up third, actually, so we'll definitely see him again. And depending on the tie, after you win three matches, the tie is over. So it all depends whether they played the last two or not. And there's another big hit from Gao.
Seven silver, 3-1.
On that, but it's not, that's what I really like when Hiroki can really mix up the shots. He does it well, and that's when he starts to win the points. He's very clever, very fast, and very clever on the court. Excellent defense. Liu really taking control of the net. When you watch her, she's very smart. Just every once in a while, take a look at her when she's on the net. She knows where to place the shot. Great defense again from Japan. Able to pull that one off and take a 1-point lead. Another big powerful smash from China.
It's over 6-7.
I'll say this to remind you of Kai. former national team player from China, the way he
yes,
able to smash the shuttle down. Important this first match is leading 8-6. Another point into the net. These are the errors that you don't need. Just snatched at that one. Really moving around the court again, sends it to the back, tries to cut it off. A fast clear, gets away with that one. Nice and steady, Ludovíková that time. A fast, flat, clear, watch how quick he is on that one. Just a mix up. Liu into the net. Number one in the world. The juniors for the mixed doubles and women's doubles.
Just listen to me. Yeah, yeah.
Also plays senior events or open events.
Just
on the junior tour and had quite a lot of success there as well. Smart that time from Saito. Takes the pressure off. Watch this. Nice, places it perfectly right to the net. Japan is in the lead in the third and final game. 11-6, 11 minutes of play. It's game three. China takes the first game. Japan fought in the second. Just barely pulls it off. And now we're in the third and final game. It's 11-6 for Japan. Artie says, I'm cheering so much my throat already hurts. Well, always in a team event, it's a little extra pressure from the country, your teammates, and always a lot of cheering going on. This is a junior team event. We play mixed doubles, women's doubles, men's doubles, a women's singles, and a men's singles. Best to three. So quick. Goes to the floor, though, on that one, Saito. Oh! Well. It was a call on that one. The umpire said you were over the net. It's a judgment call from the umpire. You can follow through on the other side after you hit the shot, but it's up to the umpire if they think you've done it beforehand or not. China's fighting its way back. It was 11-6 at the half. Three straight points. Perfect placement. Hidarikawa down the line again. Really places the shuttle perfectly. Watch that. Gets him sprawled out on court.
Thank you. On court, please.
Shot, fantastic get that time. It sails out the back. China with the big point. Just excellent get, too much. Puts it away. But again, if you watch the match, when Liu comes in so quickly, she's a fantastic mixed doubles player. Watch this, how she comes in nice and quick. That one goes to the ground. Well, in the mixed, they won two junior tournaments. Goes cross on that one. Japan, another point. To mop up the court, and he went to the ground. The umpire says quickly.
Okay.
Tries to keep the play continuous. Hits the ground. Now Japan leads this game by 5 points. Another one. Comes across the body. Liu keeps that pressure on and Saito puts it away cross court. Excellent placement. Watches, comes across. Can Japan win the first match? This is an important one. Liu won the China Masters quarterfinals at the Indonesian Masters, has a lot of experience, both in the open event and the juniors. Another great hit by Saito, definitely cutting down on her mistakes now and actually taking control of this game. Seventeen ten.
14.
The screen is stuck, so listen to me, okay? 18-10.
There's another point. Japan.
19-10.
2 points away now. It's 19-10. Japan had 5 points in a row. Now finally, Japan or China able to break it. It was a short lift.
11,
too much power comes across the body. Now China 11-19. Excellent defense. Liu finds a hole on that one. Beautiful shot. Watch how she does it.
Yes.
Hits her racket. Finds a hole.
Thank you. Players on court, please.
That gives Japan the first match point.
That is over. 20. Match point. 12.
Nice high. Mix up. Goes cross and that's it.
Yeah.
Japan pulls the first one off. Excellent play by the duo. Nice and steady at the end. Finds a hole. Down to the
match
ground.
Won by
getting it back.
Japan.
We did it.
21.
Japan
three,
takes
21, 21,
the first match.
12.
It was a battle. It was ups and downs all the way. Nice and steady. And there we have confirmation. China takes the first game 21-17. Japan fought back 23-21, and then the final 21-12. Thumbs up, well played by both these teams. Saito settled down definitely in the second and third game. Got on the net, a lot of putaways. Hirarikawa, fantastic mix up at the back of the court, really quick on his feet. And they pulled it off. Japan leads the tie, 1-0. There you have both ways. Fantastic attack, controlling the net, and that's what made the difference at the end. Great placement. Japan really controlled. Look for the holes all the way through. Well, that man right there, very powerful player. Well done, Japan. Able to pull the first one off, but there we go. Big sigh from Saito. Settled down in the second game. Really put it away. Great defense by all four players. But at the end, it was Japan that was able to take it away. Down on the ground. With the big, powerful smashes. Able to get everyone back. Again, good defense, but too much to handle. And Japan able to win first match of the World Junior Team Championships. And again, really moves from side to side all around the court. And there you have it, Japan with the win.